they had probable cause, and I, instead of doing a breathalyzer, I chose to do the blood. So, you know what I mean? I'm waiting on the results to get back in on that, and then we'll go from there.
Yeah. I guess from a fan's perspective, right, everybody's like, what's the guy doing out in the morning 2 weeks before a fight, right? So, I mean, was this just a one-night thing, or is this like, has this been a tough camp for you?
No, it was just a one-night thing, you know what I mean? Just decided to kick back and relax with my girlfriend, you know. Had a few drinks, you know, and then there's a situation that happened, and then cops got involved, and then, you know, I did have my weapon on me. My weapon is, like, it's legal, you know what I mean? It's licensed in my name, so... they made it look like I had like a Mac-10 in my lap driving around drunk or something, you know, but it's not as serious as they make it out to be. It's not like I was like drunk off my ass, hungover, you know what I mean, just running the streets, you know. It was a one-time thing.
So I guess fight week now is here, right? Is this a tough fight week for you? I mean, has this changed things at all, knowing that you're going to have to come answer this and deal with this and that sort of thing?
I mean, nah, not really. It is what it is, you know what I mean? Just got to, I'm the dumbass that did that, so you know what I mean? I just got to deal with it.
Fair enough. All right, well, moving past that, this matchup here with Santiago, a lot of people have circled as, you know, potential fight of the night type thing. What do you think about the matchup itself?
Yeah, that's how I see it too, potential fight of the night or potential performance of the night, you know? So it's going to go either way.
Nice. And I guess last thing for me, I mean, does this feel like a kind of a must-win type situation? I mean, I know you want to win every fight, right? Yeah. But, I mean, does this feel like a must-win type moment?
I feel like it's a I will win type moment, you know what I mean? So, I'm going to win this fight, you know what I mean? It's a must win, whatever, who cares? Like, I'm just here, I'm living in the moment, so I just gotta get this job done.
Geoff, right here. We spoke with Santiago a couple hours ago, and he said that this is, quote, probably going to be a war against Geoff Neal. Are you in that same camp?
Yeah, I mean, I never look at a fight like it's probably going to be a war. Like, I hope it's not a war. I hope I knock him out in the first round. But, you know what I mean, he's a tough dude, so yeah, it might be a war.
Yeah, Geoff, back here. Considering the two fight skid that you're on, did you learn anything from those losses? You know, they say that you learn more from a loss than from a win. And if so, like, what did you take away from those two?
Just gotta go in the cage with the killer mentality. You know what I mean? Like the last two fights, I really didn't approach the fights like that. It might be fighting in the apex. You know what I mean? I'm not gonna lie, fighting the apex is boring as fuck. I do not want to fight in the Apex no more. And this time I get to fight in the T-Mobile Arena, and I'm excited about that. You know what I mean? Like, fight week is fun right now. I'm just looking forward to getting there on a Saturday, walking through the arena, fans yelling and screaming. Like, I want that. I live for that.
And when Ponzinibbio returned against Liu Jingliang earlier this year, obviously it did not go his way. He got pretty viciously knocked out. Do you take any sort of, like, tips or clues from that and apply it to your own game that you think you can maybe use against him?
I mean, is it getting knocked out like that is one of those things, you know what I mean? Like, you get caught. So I don't really – I watched that fight once, and that was it, because there's nothing I'm going to take from that fight, you know what I mean? People get caught. So, you know what I mean? Then he fought the next time, had a tough fight against another dude with knockout power. He didn't get knocked out then. So it's just like – that's the fight I watch the most, you know what I mean? You get caught sometimes. I'm not saying I'm gonna walk in there and just walk through him like Legion. I'm not even gonna try to say his name, like he did, you know.
And last one for me, what would you say is the most challenging part of Ponzinibbio's game?
His jab. He has a really good jab, and he does a good job at being aggressive while not being aggressive. You know, he can jab you and then like get right out of range as soon as you try to come forward. So that's probably gonna be the toughest part.
Thank you.
Geoff, thanks for taking the time. Just a quick one. It won't be a guy using footwork and constant angles in the entire cage. Was there a part of you that was kind of relieved that you have a guy who will come forward and at you?
Yeah, for sure. Yeah, like fighting Wonderboy was like probably the hardest thing I ever had to do. Like not being able to set my feet and throw a strike or anything. But yeah, I don't know how if he's going to come forward like that. If he does come straight forward, like I really feel like that might be bad for him. But we'll see. Like people that come straight forward, I usually knock them out. So if he wants to come straight forward, then that's what the result's going to be.
Thank you, sir. Good luck on Saturday.
Thank you.
Geoff, right back here. I know you said after the last fight that you needed to take some time to get your health in order and figure a lot of things out. Can you tell us what kind of the past few months have been like and where you're at now compared to where you were then?
Yeah, the past few months have been great. Like as soon as I took the L against Magny, I went to Hawaii, had a little vacation, and then got back, went to the Dominican Republic, and then just kind of chilled and relaxed, took some time off at the gym. Once I got back, I started I implemented supplements into my my training schedule, you know what I mean? So like I'm taking supplements now, and it's really doing great for me, like my health and like how I feel and just my energy levels and stuff like that. Like I really feel like I felt before I got a sepsis. Good. Thank y'all.